Now let's continue our solution of the 2D Poisson's equation. Our functional is given as the sum of the Laplacian and this constant integrated over the surface. That's effectively two different functionals, I1 and I2. These can be found by the global coefficients here, the global functionals, can be found as the sum of local functionals, as shown here. The IE1 term is the same as the one we had for the Laplace's equation previously, and IE2 is what we want to find now. So IE2 is going to be the integral over the surface of rho times the potential over epsilon. Remember that the potential can be written as the sum of the shape functions times the potentials at the nodes, and I goes from 1 to the number of nodes, which is 3 in the case of a triangle. Let's substitute this in here. So we're going to end up with the integral over the surface, rho over epsilon, sum from 1 to 3 of alpha I phi I ds. Well, certainly this term can come outside, and if we assume that the constants are the same over the element, we can bring that outside as well. And what we're going to be left with is the sum from I equals 1 to 3 of rho over epsilon times the integral of alpha I ds times phi I. We're going to put that on the outside of the potential. So this is now going to give us the sum from I equals 1 to 3 of rho over epsilon, and then this vector right here, which is 1, 1, 1 times the area of our element times phi sub I. There's also a 3 right here. Sorry about that. Okay, now let's go to the next possibility. We're going to define a term we're going to call P. P, for any element, is going to be rho over epsilon for that element times the area of the element over 3. Now we can find these values for each individual element, and we need to figure out how to put them together to go from the local to the global coefficients. Let's number this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this will be element 1, element 2, and element 3. So if we wanted to be able to find d of the I of phi, that's going to be given as the sum of p values. So let's consider p1. This is going to be p1, p2, p3, p4, and p5. So in all cases, we're going to look for the local values that have these nodes. Let's consider node 1. How many elements have node 1? Well, element number 1 has node 1, and element number 2 has node 1, so you simply add the p1 values from each of those. How about node number 2? Well, the only one that has node number 2 is element number 1. Node number 3 is owned by both elements 2 and element 3. Node number 4 has 3 elements, p4 for element 1, plus p4 for element 2, plus p4 for element 3. p5 is only owned by element 3. So this is how we define the matrix that we're able to use to solve for the 2D Poisson's equation.